The another example shown right here is of again a hypogeal germination but in base grain. So students, I hope you may note the difference that in the previous one, the example of hypogeal germination, we have seen for pea seed. Pea seed was dicotyledonous, that means the seed were of the pea can be broken down into two equal halves. Now one for the dicot hypogeal germination we have seen, and this time we are going to see for the monocot, that is the maize grain. Maize is the monocot, and the seed cannot be broken down into two equal halves. Okay, so note down, students, please note it down, that we are now seeing for the maize grain what we are seeing, the hypogeal germination. The pattern will be the same, of course, since it is the hypogeal, that means the epicotyle will elongate. Okay, but the difference where the prior one, that the pea seed was the dicot, and this one is the monocot. This one is the monocot. So we will see this. Okay, so nothing very different. It's all same. Okay, just here is, I will make you note down, is that the coleoptile is here, and the coleoptile, or if you talk about the coleorhiza that we have already studied in when I was describing you all about the maize grain, is that this coleorhiza is a protective sheath that protects the radical. Okay, that protects the radical, but here the coleoptile is basically the sheath which protects the humule. Okay, so there are two protective sheath. One is coleoptile for the humule, another one is your coleorhiza for the radical. Okay, so students, here I would like to make you note down one more important thing, is that in this case, what happens? The plumule and the radical peers out. What do? They peers out, and then after they start coming, the radical and the plumule, they start coming outside. Okay, here you may see in the diagram, which is given very clearly, that the radical later on differentiates and develops into the root. Okay, and this plumule, if you talk about, which peers out the coleoptile, slowly develops the foliage leaves. Okay, the leaves comes out. So it is very clear, students, given nicely in this diagram or the picture representation, that how the hypogeal germination takes place in case of a maize grain. Okay, and in the same way, if you see whatever is given in your book, is that the cotyledon which is present there in case of maize grain, or if you see in any monocot seed, is that they have a scutellum. What do they have? They have scutellum. I hope you all can remember this term. 2-3 days back, we have already discussed about the scutellum. Okay, scutellum is that endosperm which surrounds the growing embryo, and this scutellum takes or absorbs its nutrition from the endosperm. And endosperm and the scutellum is basically separated out there. Okay, they are separated out there. If you can remember the diagram, there was a line of separation. There was a thin epithelium layer was there. Okay, which was the separator of the scutellum and the endosperm. I hope that you can remember it clearly, and if not, then go and check it out there in the YouTube. I have already uploaded that presentation of that class. You may search it in the YouTube in my channel, you will get it, and see this video again, and you can correlate. Okay, so scutellum absorbs, keep on absorbing the nutrition from this endosperm till the nutrition totally get exhausted, and slowly taking up of nutrition and everything leads to the development of the plant. So that's all about the hypogeal germination of maize grain. With this, we are now ending with the pattern of germination and the factor of germination. The overall topic of germination. And in the next class, we are going to study about the baby parents' germination and the seedling. With this, your chapter will be over. So, what will be your homework, students? You are going to study, you are going to revise whatever I have taught you. You may see the videos repeatedly, many a times that you want. Okay, and you have to draw figure number 6.5, 6.6 and 6.7. I repeat, you need to draw figure number 6.5, 6.6 and 6.7. Okay, and you have to write down the difference between the hypogeal germination and epigeal germination. Thank you, take care and have a good day.